How is a person, how does a person meet? And I'll tell you one story specifically. The great Sheikh Ahmed Al-Alawi, who was a Mastaghnami, he was a Sheikh from Algeria. He died in the 1930s and he was a Shadh al-Darqawi. But as a boy, he was a cobbler. He would fix people's shoes. His father was was very strict on him. He made him memorize the Quran, but he was a little, you know, traditional father. He was a very pious boy. And his mother, if I recall correctly, had a dream that the messenger of God came to her in a dream, Ali Salatu, and gave her a rose. And the meaning later is that it was Sheikh Ahmed Alawi. And anyway, there was a sheikh in the local area in Algeria named Sheikh Bouzidi. Now, he, they heard about him, very famous, but then he disappeared. Like the man just disappeared. So he would work in, he had a business with his friend. And at that time, he began to study theology with a particular sheikh. And he would go to work in the day. And he was part of a group, a spiritual movement known as the Isawiyya. And one of the things that they did was they would charm snakes. Which isn't good, but we'll see the kind of conclusion to the story. Anyway, he said, one day we were working in the shop and this imam comes in. This imam Bouzidi just happens to turn up. So I looked at him. And my friend happened to know him first, and he said, I don't know where from. So he said to me, so what's your name? He said, Manj Ahmed. He said, what do you do? He said, you know, introduced himself. He said, I heard you're a snake charmer. He said, yeah, oh, pretty good at it, yeah. He said, go and find me a snake, and I want to see, you know, your tricks, what you're good at, how skillful you actually are. So anyway, he said, I looked for half of the day, and till late afternoon, I finally found a little rattlesnake or something like that. He said, put it in a basket and brought it to the sheikh and I said, sheikh, okay. So he brings it out. He managed to charm the snake and the sheikh said, imagine charm the snake and the sheikh says to him, go get rid of it, man, go get rid of it. Gets rid of it and he comes back and he says, how good are you at charming snakes? So sheikh, you've seen me in practice, you managed to do it. He said, there's a really big snake, it's enormous. It's so big that if you are able to control it, that you'll become the Gnostic or the sage of this era. He said, what snake is that? He said, it's very venomous. Incredibly venomous. He said, what is it? He said, it's between your shoulders. It's your nafs. If you master it, then you will become the sage of this era. At that point, he swore allegiance to the sheikh. And he had found out that his friend had already done it, but was kept in secret. Sheikh Bouzidi later said to him that he was not permitted to take any disciples by the messenger of God himself, alayhi salatu wasalam, until he had given allegiance to him, meaning this young man. He became a great man of God, a great sage. He's very recent. I mean, some pictures of him on the internet as well. Now there are stories about him, for instance, where he talks about this kind of connection to this world, and one of the conditions that they mention is that the spiritual master does not take the student unless he can recognize him from that particular time period that precedes this existential life that we have in this world, that precedes a very deep spiritual, meaning. He never had any children, the Sheikh. He passed away at the age of around 70 something, if I'm correct. I think so. One thing really amazing about him, he said that I was studying theology and the sheikh said to me that don't stop studying theology. And he said, it really hurt me because I enjoyed my lessons. We studied, you know, the sifat of Allah. And he said, I was about to leave the sheikh. And he said, forget it, you know, I can't do this anymore. You're taking me away from my lessons. And what happened to him was, he said, I left, I bit my tongue, I left the lesson. He said, then a day came where the sheikh said, go back to your lesson. And he went back and he said that, whenever the sheikh mentioned a point, he said, immediately I could understand it. He said, it got to a point where I began to have panic attacks, anxiety. And he said that I didn't know what to do. And I went to the sheikh and the sheikh said, take a pen and a paper and you'll see what happens. So as soon as I had a panic attack, he said, I began to write. And he eventually ended up completing a tafsir of the Quran. That all of it was from essential inspiration from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's what was contained inside of him. And it's in print as well, he's the Sheikh's tafsir. But this kind of shows you that connection between people and a kind of that just almost replays in this world of great sages and great Gnostics of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. His story when he died, actually, a French doctor, non-Muslim, was treating him, and he was very ill, and the French doctor came, gave him an injection, revived him. 2 years later, the Shaykh called him around Dhuhr time. No, before that, maybe 11 or 12 o'clock. And he said to him, said to the doctor, come back at Dhuhr time, I'm going to die. This is a non-Muslim reporting this story. So he said to him, oh, you're going to die. Look at the, you look perfectly fine to me. He said, you just come back and I'm going to die at that time. Just come back at this particular time. So he said, like, and he was dying. And he looked at my face. He said, dare you put any injection in me today? He said, it's time to go. And then he died. And he was a great man of God. And but it kind of it infers he's a lot of stories that we read about him. It's all about this constant connection to and unlocking that secret within the soul about our meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The end of that verse, it stated, أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ قَالُوا بَلَىٰ. The last part is probably the most important, which is shahidna. Shahidna. Shahidna means we have witnessed it. We have witnessed it, which is incredible. Sheikh Abdul Aziz Dabagh actually states that there were some people on that day that when God said, أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ, am I not your Lord? They said no. And he said, وَأُولَيْكَ الْكُفَّارِ. So they are the disbelievers on, in the world, that they even denied God after he created them. You see, they wanted proof from God even when... And he divides them into four people, four categories of people. And he says that the mu'minun were the ones who said, Bala, shahidina, we have witnessed